Guys, and welcome back to the Universe Mode here. As you are now seeing on screen, we have a huge announcement to make here on the beginning of the episode. Due to Tommaso Ciampa's knee injury, he is not able to defend the NXT tag team titles with his partner Johnny Gargano, and thus Johnny Gargano has found a new tag team partner in the form of Cassius. Oh no! And now we have a new tag team for our tag team champions. It is Johnny Gargano and Cassius Ohno, who I have thankfully named Gargano. So we have our new NXT tag team champions. What does this new tag team entail for the rest of the tag team division? We'll have to find out here in the coming weeks, as I believe our next episode will be their debut match, and that will be pretty interesting. But getting into tonight's action, we are actually starting off with a promo from Lars Sullivan. We closed out last week's episode with Aleister Black challenging Lars Sullivan, so we're going to hear his response here tonight. So what does Lars Sullivan have to say with all this? I mean, Lars Sullivan was supposed to have a matchup here tonight, so perhaps we are going to see exactly what Aleister Black is getting into tonight as he takes on Riddick Moss. Oh, man, and Riddick just runs right into a brick wall. Are you kidding me? Already? Oh, the freak accident. Is that it? One, two, that's it. Lars Sullivan with a quick win over Riddick Moss using the freak accident. And just like Aleister Black, he's able to beat opponents in quick succession. Perhaps Aleister Black, I mean, I know Aleister, he's one hell of a superstar here on the roster, but perhaps he's having second thoughts at challenging Lars Sullivan here, as he just beat Riddick Moss in a matter of seconds. Looks like Aleister Black did with his older opponents. Oh, and Lars Sullivan lifting up Riddick Moss and tossing him over the top rope. Oh, man. And Riddick maybe out. Uh-oh. And Lars Sullivan, look at this, sends a message. Oh, to Aleister Black, another freak accident. And following up from NXT TakeOver Respect, with the women's division mounting here with several competitors vying for a position for the NXT Women's Championship, and with Ruby Riott's recent victory over Nikki Cross in that no disqualification matchup, many people are saying that Ruby Riott is the next woman to face off against Ember Moon for the NXT Women's Championship, now that we know Nia Jax is no longer in NXT, so we have no rematch between Ember Moon and Nia Jax. So many people are saying either Ruby Riott or Kairi Sane should be the number one contender. Oh, wait, Lana. And so if Ruby Riott is able to beat Lana here tonight, who also has had a string of victories up her sleeve, perhaps we could be looking at Ruby Riott versus Ember Moon at our next TakeOver event, or perhaps even sooner here on NXT. And Ruby Riott starting things off here. Still feeling some of the effects from that matchup with Nikki Cross. That was a hell of a match. If you guys didn't go and watch it, either I'll put together just a video of just that matchup by itself, or maybe I'll link you guys to the video in the video description or in the comment section. It'll be pinned to the top of the comment section. But Ruby Riott and Nikki Cross, they had a hell of a match, and now Ruby Riott facing off against the Ravishing Russian here tonight in our main event on NXT. Lana, oh man, perhaps, I don't know if Lana's ever main evented a Universe Mode episode before. This is Lana's main event debut here on the Universe Mode, unless I'm mistaken. Oh man, Or no, wait, Lana has been in the main event matchup on our Universe mode before. It was her debut match. She was in the main event against Mia Yim, defeating Mia Yim. Oh, and now look at that. Look at that. She's really holding her own against Ruby Riott. And now they take the fight out of the ring. Oh, and get sent. Did you hear that? She friggin' dinged right off the friggin' barricade. Oh, and a snap suplex out on the floor. Ruby Riott. Oh, nice knee strike. And Riott. Oh, she's. The crowd's wanting to see Lana get her head slammed into the steel stairs. Oh, man. And Lana says, no, you do not. And instead, sends her into the ring. And now back into the ring we go. Ruby Riott trying to hold on. Oh, look at this. Gets dropped right onto the turnbuckle. Oh, man. Lana had her up in a power slam position, aimed right for the turnbuckle. Will that be it? No, the kick out from Ruby Riott. Ooh, man. She's really gonna have to fight her way out of this. Oh, and indeed she does, fighting her way back up to a vertical base. And imagine everything Ruby Riott went through in that matchup, and look at that. Getting launched out of the ring, much like what happened in the no disqualification matchup. Ruby Riott sacrificing her own body to put Nikki Cross through a table on the outside. Oh, and perhaps those lingering injuries may be her downfall here tonight. Oh, and a running kick on the outside. That could be enough to put down Ruby Riott, but all she's got to do is put her in the ring. You can't pin her outside. Unless it was false count anywhere, which this is not. Riott trying to fight out. Referee at a count of seven. Thankfully, both women are seemingly back inside the ring. Oh, and a... what the heck was that? Some sort of like a senton, but it barely caught Lana. Seemingly not enough to put away Lana, and indeed it is not, considering that was a rope break. Oh, and now they're away from the ropes, and Lana still able to kick out. Looks like she grazed the top of her head. Seeming like a headbutt with her butt. Oh, man. Ruby sends her into the corner. Oh, and Lana bouncing off the turnbuckle pad. Oh, running drop kick. Very nice. Lana with a string of victories. That streak could come to an end here. Oh. I believe her only loss here in the Universe mode is to the NXT Women's Champion Ember Moon. She would love to get back to the mountaintop and facing off against Ember Moon again, this time for the Women's Championship. As Ruby Riott, oh, maybe sending her down the pecking order with those super kicks. Oh, Ruby Riott, oh, look for a splash, and Lana moved out of the way. Oh, super kick. Oh, no, wait. Reverses and hits a nice knee to the face. And Riott going up again. And senton bomb from off the top rope. And perhaps that's enough to put away the Ravishing Russian 2 and a kick out. Interesting sequence. Riott misses with a splash. Lana went for a super kick. Oh, and Ruby Riott screaming, Riott! Tonight, we start a riot indeed. If Riott wins, we riot. Oh, no, Lana. Oh, spins around. What is this? A kill switch? Oh, no, wait, with added assistance. Oh, kill switch, bulldog, almost. Oh, and right to the spine of Ruby Riott. Lana going after those nagging injuries. Oh, and that's Ruby Riott's move. Riott just hit Ruby Riott's, or Lana just hit Ruby Riott's Riott kick. Two and a three. Wow, Lana. Lana just beat Ruby Riott using her own finishing maneuver. A Riott kick. Oh, man. I don't know what you chalk that up to. Nagging injuries or perhaps just a fluke. Oh, man. I mean, that could have beaten Lana right there, but man, out of nowhere. A Riott kick by Lana beats Ruby Riott. Well, perhaps That definitely does change the pecking order of the NXT Women's Championship. And who will face Ember Moon? Perhaps it might be Lana, as she has just beaten Ruby Riott, a woman that many people say should be the number one contender. I mean, what happens when someone beats the number one contender? Lana has indeed just put that question into our minds here tonight.